Hello, you are welcome into the lecture Psychoactive Substances. During the lecture, you will observe groups, medical use and disorders related to psychoactive substances abuse. A psychoactive substance or psychopharmaceutical drug changes brain function and includes stimulants, which excite brain activity, depressants, which inhibit brain activity, hallucinogens, which distort perceptions, etc. The first treaty designed to control psychoactive drugs was the Convention on Psychotropic Substances of United Nations that came into force in 1971. On this slide, you can see an assortment of psychoactive drugs, which are used as street drugs and medications. Cocaine, also known as coke, is a strong stimulant most frequently used as a recreational drug. Cocaine acts by inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Cocaine had been used as pain reliever, but its importance has decreased during other synthetic local anesthetics using. Ritalin is a stimulant medication used to treat attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. Ephedrine is a stimulant. In medicine, it is often used to prevent low blood pressure during spinal anesthesia, also for asthma, narcolepsy, and act as bronchodilators. Ephedrine by itself is not a narcotic drug, but is used as precursor for illegal synthesis of psychoactive stimulant ephedrone. Psychoactive drug ecstasy was first synthesized as substance against abnormal bleeding. Lysergic acid diethylamide, or LSD, is a hallucinogenic drug and long time had been used in psychiatry. Mescaline is a naturally occurring psychedelic photoalkaloid of known for its hallucinogenic effects, comparable to those of LSD. Mescaline is biosynthesized from terazine. Cannabis is a psychoactive drug from the cannabis plant used primarily for medication or recreational purposes. The main psychoactive part of cannabis is tetrahydrocannabinol, the structure of which you can see on slide. Tetrahydrocannabinol was first isolated in 1969 in Israel. Tetrahydrocannabinol is an active ingredient of nabiximols, is sold as a mouth spray intended to alleviate neuropathic pain, spasticity, and other symptoms of multiple sclerosis. And dronabinol is used for HIV-AIDS-induced anorexia and chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting only. The high lipid solubility of cannabinoids results in their persisting in the body for long periods of time. Even after a single administration of tetrahydrocannabinol, detectable levels of tetrahydrocannabinol can be found in the body for weeks or longer, depending on the amount administered and the sensitivity of the assessment method. Tetrahydrocannabinol exerts its most prominent effects via its actions on two types of cannabinoid receptors. The CB1 receptor is found primarily in the brain and in some peripheral tissues, and CB2 receptor is found primarily in peripheral tissues, but is also expressed in neurological cells. Tetrahydrocannabinol appears to alter mood and cognition through its agonist action in the CB1 receptor. which inhibit a secondary messenger system, adenylate cyclase, in a dose-dependent manner. Via CB1 receptor activation, tetrahydrocannabinol indirectly increases dopamine release and produces psychotropic effect. Also acts as an allosteric modulator of the opioid receptors. Tetrahydrocannabinol also potentiates the effect of the glycine receptors. Cannabis has various mental and physical effects, which include euphoria, altered states of mind and sense of time, difficulty concentrating, impaired short-term memory and blood and body movement, relaxation, etc. Opioids are substances that act on opioid receptors to produce morphine-like effects. Opiate is a term classically used in pharmacology to mean a drug derived from opium. Activation of the opioid receptor decreases calcium influx in response to incoming action potential. This decreases release of excitatory neurotransmitters such as glutamate. Activation of the opioid receptor increases potassium efflux and decreases the response of the postsynaptic neuron to excitatory neurotransmitters. Morphine and other poppy-based medicines have been identified by the World Health Organization as essential in the treatment of severe pain. Opioid morphine is essential in pain due to cancer. Methadone is essential in the treatment and used in replacement therapy for opioid use disorders. Buprenorphine is used due to opioid use disorders. Butorphanol is a pain reliever. It is included in first aid kit. Also, opioids are used for pain, mild pain relief, suppression of diarrhea, etc. Opioids can produce strong feeling of euphoria, and related to drug misuse and non-medical use include the use of four reasons or at doses other than prescribed. On this slide, you can see most commonly abused opiates. Risk factors of abuse disorders include biological and environmental. On this slide, you can see codes of psychoactive substance use disorders. For more detailed information, you can follow the link. Long-term medical effects of dependence include psychiatric, cardiovascular, hepatic, behavioral, respiratory, etc. disorders. Withdrawal symptoms depend on severity of abuse, type of psychoactive substances, etc. For example, opiate withdrawal can linger for weeks or months. There are three pharmaceuticals are used for opioid use disorders. Methadone acts by binding to the mu opioid receptor, but also has some affinity for the N-methyl D-aspartate receptor and anionic glutamate receptor. Buprenorphine affects different type of opioid receptor in different ways. Depending on the type of receptor, it may be an agonist, partial agonist, or antagonist. Naltrexone and its active metabolite are competitive antagonists at the mu opioid receptor. Volatile solvents, such as those found in fuel, paints, and thinners, are found throughout the world and are used in a variety of industrial applications. On this slide, you can see some examples of those. Research on the abuse potential and addictive properties of volatile solvents has lagged behind that of other illicit drugs of abuse. Inhalant abuse can also lead to major cognitive impairments in short-term memory, attention, response inhibition, and problem solving, etc. Treatment methods include usually advice from physicians or social workers, family and special group support, self-help, etc. Conclusions related to psychoactive substance use disorder you can see on this slide. Thank you for your attention.